So Geoffrey, your philosophy, and I was stunned once to read about you sort of saying in a nutshell, don't give up, like just don't give up on kids. But your philosophy around education to me seems to be more about how the world is changing and they need to be prepared for a changing world.
Yes, well, you know, I think our poor children, our children, children of color, are often so limited in their view of themselves and of the world, of who they are. So much of that has been intentional. You know, when I think, if folks haven't seen the movie Hidden Figures, about these African-American women who were called computers and helped get the first astronaut to the moon. I mean, when I grew up when this was all happening, I loved the astronauts. I didn't know a Black person was anywhere involved in this. And if I would have heard Black women, they were the smartest mathematicians in the United States, it would have changed how all kinds of folks who were growing up in those communities thought about themselves, thought about their abilities. Black girls would not be thinking, math is not for me. I'm not good in math. I can't do it. They'd be saying, of course I'm good in math. Look at what we do as a people. This has been hidden from us. Those visions of ourselves have been removed. So my belief is we've got to rebuild into our young people an ability to expand their vision of themselves. I gotta let them know the world is larger than Harlem. It's larger than New York. And your place in it might be in Harlem, but it might be somewhere, maybe in LA. It might be in Philadelphia. That this ability to prepare young people for a world that is going to change constantly. That the job you have now is not gonna be the job you're gonna have in 5 years and the job you're gonna have in 10 years. Our young people have to be prepared for that. And I think you do that by giving them a world-class education. You give them an education and you expose them to things that blows their minds, right? That they say, wow, I didn't know you were going to take me there. So yeah, do we sponsor trips for our kids to go over to Africa? Absolutely. Do I think that's part of their education? Sure it is. Do we send our kids to a school in the Bahamas where they teach them to swim in the ocean with sharks? Yeah, I wouldn't do it. Just for the record, but these kids want that experience, and it's great for them because it changes your life when you've got experiences like that. And you know, the part, Soledad, that where I think Pharrell and I are in sync when it comes to education is we want to offer young people a world-class view of their abilities, and we want to expose them to lots of things they would have never come in contact with. And he's going to count on folks like me to make sure they have the best curriculum and the best teachers. But this idea of how do you imbue young people with a spirit that brings them joy, that joy isn't from alcohol and drugs, but it's because I can play music or I'm a great dancer or I'm a wonderful poet. This is what we have to do to save our kids. And I think that I'm counting on him to bring his expertise into this, and he's counting on me to bring my expertise into this while we create something new for the young people in Virginia.